Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. This is Moses. Today we're going to learn about Tally, but specifically we're going to learn how to create users and how to limit their access to the company data. As usual, you just open normally your Tally application. Okay, here you just click on select company, and you select your desired company. What you do, you go to company info and you go to outer. You select the company you want to edit. Now you go down, okay, you go to security control, you change this, there is a line here saying use security control, you type yes, okay, here you type the administrator name. I'm going to put admin and I'm going to put the password. Again, here we repeat the password. Okay, forgetting your password will render your data inaccessible. So after creating the password, make sure that you remember it. Enter. Accept to save. Okay, let us confirm our changes. I'm going to open the data again. Select company. You see now it is asking for username and password. I'm going to put username is admin. And here I put the password. Now it is entered, it is accepting. Now the next step, the first step we're creating the administrator account. Now the next step, we're going to create user accounts. Okay, accounts info, just a moment. Let us first see company info. We go to security control. We go to security types first. Go to data entry. We're going to call what we're going to do. Let us first create the users. Okay, this user we're going to put this user under data entries. Let me call this user Ash. Let me just call him Arthur. Okay. And also, I'll also put the password for this user. When I can put the mobile number. Okay. Enter. If you want to add another user, but for now we're going to add only one user. Just say end, Okay, now here, in types of security, we're going to select data entry. Okay, and here use basic facilities of, I guess, again, we're going to put data entry, enter. Now here we have everything in full control, disallowed. It means if we leave this user at with these settings, this user will not be able to do anything. Okay? We will not be able to edit anything, we will not be able to transact. And what the reason why you are creating this user account, the limitation is supposed to be like, this user is not supposed to delete any voucher. Okay, so what we're going to do here, we're going to type outer. Okay, it means this user will see everything but will not delete or modify. Okay, we'll put everything at outer. Okay, outer. Outer. Okay, now even backdated voucher, it means that this user will not be able to backdate, like to create vouchers which are not in the current date. Okay, like for example, if the date is for today, this user will not be able to create vouchers which were supposed to be for yesterday. I hope you understand. Okay, let us leave this one. Okay, now let us first log out. Let us first close the company. We're going to open our Tally program again. Now we're going to log in with our new user account. Okay. The user account was Arthur. And the password. Okay. This user was created. Okay. Select company. Okay, let us first shut company. Okay. Arthur. Okay, as you can see, this user is able to do everything apart from there's something missing here. Okay, this user is supposed to view the reports. Okay. Yes. can do anything with the reports. Let me see if this user can delete vouchers. Let me see. Delete. This user can delete this voucher because we didn't restrict it. Okay. But as you can see, this user has some features which are missing here. Okay. So we limited those ones. Let me show you to give you an example of what I'm talking about. Okay, if I use the admin account, okay, you can see that this is the account for admin and this is the account for author. You can see that some features are disabled here. You can see payroll info, it is not here. Now it is here, but accounts info is not available here. Inventory info is not available here. So guys, that is how we limit users from accessing certain features in the Tally ERP9. Thank you for watching. If you find this video helpful, please don't forget to subscribe. You can put a comment below just to let me know how you feel about this video. In case you want me to do more videos about like this, you can mention what you need exactly to learn in Tally ERP9 so that I can do another video for that. I might miss out something, but you can with your comment you can help me to remind me. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.